So we had an issue or a challenge of getting people the data they needed, especially data for just everyday tasks. We used to print a book. It was a big book of just stats for our office and for the university. And that's a very time-consuming process. And so before SAS, we just had to do that, and it was just a very manual process. So we provided data in a big institutional profile. It was printed. It was one time a year. And as soon as we printed that, we'd had requests to have that updated for another college or another dean. And that took a lot of time. It would take 2 or 3 weeks just to get the printing right because things change, charts change because of different stats that people want. So we weren't able to give them the data they needed in a quick manner. Now we can update that data every day if we need to, but we provide that data once a semester now instead of once a year. And then they can update it themselves anytime they want. They can go change the stats that they want. They can change the graphs that they want. They can change the population of students they want in a way that we could just never do before SAS. But now with SAS, we can do it dynamically. We can have people do their own reports for themselves. And it's just really kind of changed the way we deliver data to people. SAS provided us a platform where we could really look at data in a new way, in a new format, and in ways that we never thought possible for us just because of the systems that we had in place at the time. We needed something that was not just visuals. We needed something that could do the statistics, that could do the predictive analytics. We also need something that could handle the data management needs that we have. We're a large institution. We have multiple campuses. We have multiple institutions that we manage, and so we needed a way to manage the data for all of those students and all of the different forms that we have. And so we needed a tool that could do that, and SAS was the only one that we could find. Before SAS, all of our data was presented in charts or in tables, and so it was sometimes just numbers. And so now with SAS Visual Analytics, we can actually see the data, we can see trends, they jump out at you. So it's really let us show the capabilities of data and data science and really impact our university in ways that we never thought possible. We created a report this year that we call a grade distribution report. It was a report that we've had before. It was very specific to a specific office. And so a college might say, we need to know our grade distribution for this specific course. And so they would just look at the grade distribution, say we have this many A's, this many B's, this many C's, and they might look at it over time. But what we weren't able to do is look at the whole picture, look at the whole picture of how grading was done at our institution. Were we having more A's given, more B's earned, more C's earned, more D's, where people were drawing in rates that we didn't really look at because we were only doing that on a case-by-case basis. And so this year we created a report that looked over the past 4 years at grade distribution and looked at the change of those grades. And it really changed the way that our faculty think about grade distribution. They thought it was punitive. And it's not punitive. It's really a way to see, okay, are things that we're changing the curriculum making students more successful? And so they can see those, or we can look at those things over time now in very detailed level or very macro level and look at the whole university. And so that grade distribution report came out just a few weeks ago for our campus, and it's already changed the way some of the faculty members are talking about how they teach. They can show that, oh my gosh, 2 years ago, my grade distribution was 80% A's, B's, and C's, and then it was 20% failures. Now it's 30% failures. What happened? Did the student body change? Were the people coming into our class different? Did my teaching change? Was something going on with me that semester? And so those are all things that are questions that we can answer now or thinking about that we never were before. Before we were just saying we had an 80% success rate and a 20% failure rate. Now we can say we have an 80% failure rate and we know why. We know why those 80% people are succeeding, and we know why the 20% are failing. We've also looked at things like classroom utilization, just how we use our space. As a state institution, resources are really important for us and the dwindling resources that we have. And so we want to make sure that we are using everything to our disposal in the best way. And so we were able to use SAS to modify a process that we've been doing for years, a very manual process, and a process actually we hadn't updated in 5 or 6 years just because it was so manual, where we would go in and we had someone that would sit down and make check marks in a spreadsheet to determine when classes were being used, how many people were in a specific time slot across campus. So we do a lot of research on, okay, our student growth in this major, our student growth overall, the changes in the curriculum, those kind of things. But then we started saying, really, do we need another building to do that? Could we just use the buildings we have better. And so this process saved us time and not doing this research that we didn't really need to do in the growth of a campus and all and the growth of a program. We could really just focus on what we already had. How could we use the resources we had better? And so it just really changed how we talk about our space utilization and our seat utilization. And so it's really helped us kind of think about problems in a new way and solve those problems in a new way, just because it's just easier. Our users really love SAS. They often comment about they just love how they can get in anytime, anywhere, and look at the data. And so for us, SAS Visual Analytics has given us the power to just look at the data and see things that they've never seen before. They nerd out a little bit on the data, and they like that. And so for us, we like that as well, because then they're answering their own questions, and then they're allowing us to do other things, research more, do other topics of research. So it's been great for them. So our executives love it as well. They like to go in and just be able to open up one report and see all the information they need. So we've been able to create dashboards that pull together many sources of data. For an executive that's on the run to a meeting, they can pull it up on their iPad and look at the data, know what they need to know for the meeting, and move on. It's not something they, you know, have to call us 2 weeks ahead of time so we can put together a chart and print it out for them and run it over their office. A lot of the times now they just pull up their iPad or on their phone and just look at it and like, okay, now I know what I need to know and go on. We have had comments before from our administration about how now that data is out there for everyone, that this data, because we were making it available to most people on campus, that they didn't have to provide the data, explain it before the meeting. They could come into a meeting having all of the data already looked at. They can just now start discussing the issue at hand. For us, data analytics has really changed the way we think about data and think about how we answer questions. And so for us, it's really about giving people the basic data, and then really thinking about the next question. And for us, it's always about the next question. What is the next thing we need to be doing? We don't need to be counting students anymore. We need to be talking about why that count is the way it is. Why are those students, the student population growing? Why is it getting smaller? What can we do to improve that? So for us, it's changed the questions. It's really changed the way that we think about our problems. It's no longer, oh, we can find the, you know, let's get the data and have another meeting and look at the data. It's here's the data, it's already here. But now, can we model? Can we do some predictive modeling on why these students are successful? What we could be doing to help them be more successful? We know things are happening, we know trends are going on, but now we're trying to figure out why. We're trying to figure out the things that we can do to make those trends go in the direction we want. If we want something to be better, we want something to slow down, we're working on the ways to identify how to do things. And so that's a lot different than just pointing out that a trend is happening. Now we can say, this trend is happening. Here are three ideas that we've come up with on how we can change that. So for us, it's really changed the conversation. It's no longer about the counts of things. It's about how we can do things better. And for me, that's really important. In about 5 months, we were able to source and purchase and have our first report out, which was our fact book. And so it was really important for us that we give some quick wins to our administration to show them that the investment that we had made, not only in money, but in time, was valuable. And so we were able to push out a report that they had seen as a static document for years that they carried around that was bound and printed and not a great document, but it was something that every university produces and they've always done it. And so we were able to push that out in a way that they could take it with them on their iPhone or their iPad. They didn't have to print it out. They could really filter down the results of the fact book to the specific college or even a specific department or even just a group of students to see how that has changed over time, and just something we weren't able to do before. And then really expand that to doing multi-year comparisons. And so instead of just putting out one fact book and saying, here's the results of 2017 or 18, here's the results of 17, 18, and 19, and how 19 compares to 17 in a ways that we couldn't ever do before with a static document. So SAS helped us out a lot with the showing value. They gave us ideas on some things that we could do quickly, that they knew we could do quickly, because they were with us through the whole process. They knew what the goals were for our organization. They knew our data because they had helped us move some of that data over and really try to get it ready for visual analytics. And so SAS helped us identify what would give us the best wins based on their knowledge of the product and what it could do and just their knowledge of our institution. And then they also gave us some ideas on, here's what you should do to really show them that this is more amazing. Like, no one else is doing this. Why don't y'all do it? Show it to us, show it to your campus so they can see the value of it and really help out your institution, maybe other campuses as well. SAS has been a great partner for us in getting our solutions implemented on campus. We use SAS Consulting. We also have used SAS, the free solutions of SAS Community. We also use our just SAS contacts, you know, people that we've met over time. You call them or send them an email, and they're great about sending back solutions or possible ways to look at this problem or someone else to contact that might be able to help you or another campus that's doing what you're doing. And so SAS has been invaluable to that. For us, it was key to have executive buy-in. We had support from the top. Our VP for our office also works for IT. And so having his support was invaluable. Having him say, you know what, this is something we need to be able to do. This office needs to be able to do this. We need the support financially to do that. But we also need the support from IT, from other data sources to make sure that this is working correctly. And so having that executive buy-in was key to our success. Having the executive buy-in really helped other people know that it was important, that we weren't just on our mission to have this new system, that it really was important for the university system-wide to have one source of data in a way that people would use it and that was visual and that was giving data to more people that needed it when they needed it. So I think also for changing culture, it's really important to get buy-in. Giving people access to data gives you a really good way to get buy-in. There's people out there starving for it. And if you can give it to them, it also gives you a way to explain the data, explain what you think the data means, get their insights, and really kind of get them to buy into the culture as well. It's like, oh, we really need to be using data to inform our decisions, not these anecdotes, using real data. And giving them the data is the first step, but then also sitting down with them, explaining the data, really getting to understand how they understand the data and what it means is going to be also important. We do a lot of training sessions with our faculty and staff to talk about just basic reports, how to access them, how to use a Cowboy Data Roundup, as we call it. But it's also important to have training on what the data means. You know, giving someone access to the amount of A's, B's, and C's they have is great. But what does that mean? How does that impact the university? How could that impact you by understanding your data? And so that's really important. And we have spent a lot of time training our faculty and staff, having opportunities for them to ask us questions and really kind of explain data to them in a way that they can understand it and make sure they use it. Because ultimately, that's what we want, is for them to use the data. And so helping that, giving them the information they need is important, but training them how to use it is also important. But it also gives you an opportunity to hear from them. Oh, I didn't realize that. Or why, what's this next, what's, here's another question that this raises for me, which when they're using the data and they're on the ground level, that's really important, getting those ground level questions. I think SAS offers an institution that's really interested in having a data-informed kind of culture. They give you the tools that you need, all of the tools. They give you the tools to make sure that your data is structured in the way it needs to be structured to answer the questions. Gives you the statistics background you need to validate your questions, validate the data, validate the trends that you're seeing, but also gives you the ability to think about what's next. You can learn, use machine learning, which is not something that a lot of people in higher ed are doing. Use machine learning to help you figure out some of these trends. It gives you the tools that you can do those things. Increasingly, our world is judged by how businesses are operating, especially in higher education. And so we need to be using the cutting edge tools to show the value to our constituents, to our legislatures, to our regulators, that we are doing everything possible. We are using data. We're using every statistical model out there. We're using every tool at our disposal to show results, to show that the value of what we do. We currently use SAS in our office to do a lot of reporting and a lot of analytics, but we are going to expand that into working with our other branch campuses and agency campuses that we have so that they can also use SAS. So we'll use SAS across all of the institutions in our system soon, but also trying to learn doing more predictive modeling, predicting why certain things are happening and using SAS and all the tools it has available to do that for many offices across campus, not just with student data, but with HR data, with finance data, figuring out why we're spending so much money on one thing or how, you know, has there been an increase in how we're spending things? Those are all interesting things that I think SAS gives us the ability to look at that we haven't been doing yet.